Manga demographics make no sense and make me want to die. So I was planning to make my haul video soon, but my order got delayed a few days. Hopefully it'll still be out next week. But in the meantime, please enjoy this unhinged rant. Manga demographics, okay? You got shonen for boys, seinen for men, shoujo for girls, and josei for women. Two things I want to discuss. First being people's, you know, complete lack of understanding of what these terms actually mean, and how manga publishers don't seem to know what they mean either. One of my biggest pet peeves being in the manga community for so long, and I've never really talked about it, but it's always annoyed me. It's when people equate demographic to genre. You see this most with shonen manga. A lot of people probably don't even know what shonen actually means. They probably just think it means action manga for teenagers. I see this so often, at least once a week, people thinking that shonen just means action manga. I think one of the reasons why this misconception happens so much in the Western culture is just because when, you know, anime first started coming here, most of the big stuff was under the Shonen Jump brand, you know, Dragon Ball, the Big Three, Yu Yu Hakusho, that type of stuff. It was all under Shonen Jump. They advertised it as Shonen Jump. They put it on the manga volumes. And when the English Shonen Jump publication, you know, first came out, it was mostly action manga. But in reality, if you actually look at Shonen Jump throughout, like, all points of its history, only like half of it has been action manga. Sure, the biggest ones are action manga, but if you look in the pages at like any time, you'll see like a shitload of gag series. There's usually a few romances going on, some, you know, maybe non-action thrillers. But this whole thing isn't just for shonen. I mean, a lot of people look at seinen manga and they think of, you know, like this dark, gritty, mature story, Berserk, Vinland Saga, Vagabond. This is the hardcore shit made for adults, no kids allowed in here. Then you see that one of, if not the most popular seinen in the world right now is a romantic comedy, which a lot of people generally associate with the shoujo demographic. This is the girly shit. This is where all your romance goes, all your lovey-dovey feminine bullshit. Nothing else in here. We're not even gonna bother with it. Hey, what's this? A manga that was classified as a shoujo and a seinen? There always seems to be this disconnect with people not understanding the difference between these demographics and the genre. Like, I read two shonen manga recently, Kengan Ashura and Watamote. I mean, like, seriously, you can't think of two series that are so different from each other. And probably if you asked a lot of these people what Kengan Ashura was, they'd probably guess it was seinen. Like, this guy right here obviously just assumed that these two series were shoujo because they have romance in them. Like, what the fuck? He's also a dumbass. Read Yamada and Silent Voice, they're great. The main point I'm getting at here is I just don't see a point in mentioning demographics at all, really, because they are so vague. They encompass so many different types of series and genres, and a lot of times, these classifications just don't make any sense. So let's focus on these publishers here and see what the fuck they're doing. I mentioned I read Kengan Ashura, okay? I've also read The Record of Ragnarok. These are two tournament series that are just non-stop fighting. And in terms of subject matter, you know, the level of blood and gore and sex and swearing, I'd say they're about the same, right? So then why is one a shonen and one a seinen? It's almost like it doesn't fucking matter. On Titan and Tokyo Ghoul are two other series that I would pretty much equate in terms of subject matter, yet one is a shonen and one is a seinen. Happiness is a manga that I think, compared to Tokyo Ghoul, is way more explicit in terms of its, you know, its gore, its sex, its subject matter, yet that is a shonen series. You see how this is sort of melting my brain here? Where do you draw the line in subject matter? And you're like, okay, well, these are all different publishers, maybe they just have different standards. And I agree, according to the most trusted name in news, Wikipedia, after listing, you know, like all of the things the demographics usually entail, they're like, but at the end of the day, it doesn't fucking matter because it's just up to whatever magazine they're serialized in. So it's really the publishers being like, all right, this we'll aim this at adults, put it in the seinen, we'll aim this at kids, put it in the shonen. So Shueisha saw Tokyo Ghoul, and based on their standards, they're like, all right, this we need to aim this at a more older audience, so we'll put this in our seinen magazine. Perfect, makes perfect sense. But then they get Chainsaw Man, they get Haunted Hot Springs, and they're like, okay, this is perfectly fine for children. Like, I'll admit, I don't read much shoujo and josei, so, you know, most of these examples are coming from my experience reading shonen and seinen. And from that, I just think that, you know, differentiating these series based on demographic is really dumb, because a lot of times it just makes no sense. And I think, you know, like, calling something shonen or seinen kind of puts, like, this stigma, this expectation on it. I feel like a lot of people think, you know, if they're going to read a shonen, they're always going to expect to read something like One Piece. People read a seinen, they're always going to expect something like Berserk, when in reality, none of of this matters at all. Viz tried to do this Shonen Jump Advance thing, you remember that, where they had their more mature series labeled as Shonen Jump Advanced? But what made Assassination Classroom more advanced than, like, One Piece or Naruto? Was it because it was about killing? They kill people in One Piece and Naruto. What's going on? JoJo's Bizarre Adventure started off as a shonen, then it went to a seinen magazine, and the subject matter barely changed at all. So many examples, man. Every time I talk about this shit, I lose my mind. One final thing, Gekiga. What the fuck is a Gekiga, okay? If you listen to the podcast, you've heard this boomer here say it a few times. And I've heard people talk about it here and there. Gekiga. So Gekiga is a type of manga that is mature. It's for adults. It has a more mature art style, more mature themes. It's not a demographic because it's basically just like a cool kids club. Wikipedia equates it to people who call comic books graphic novels. And I'm thinking, okay, so this is probably just means, like, you know, the really serious stuff. The stuff that doesn't play around, it just wants to tell a very serious story. Then I look at the examples here, and it's full of fucking shonen. Why is Spider-Man a Gekiga? I haven't read Spider-Man the manga, but why is this a Gekiga and Monster isn't? I have read Phoenix. I feel like that's the only manga classified as a Gekiga that I have read. And not only can it be goofy as fuck, but it ran in a shonen and shoujo magazine. I don't know if I should even trust Wikipedia on this. Like, someone please, in the comments, if you know what a Gekiga is, let me know. Because if it's just a fancy term for serious manga, who gives a fuck? My final point is demographics don't matter. That's why I've pretty much stopped mentioning them in my reviews the past year. If you want to recommend the manga to someone, just tell them the genre. Tell them what it's about. I don't know if I'll be able to do much to stop this generalization, equating demographics to genre, but I'd like to try a little bit. So that's all I had to say, just something I wanted to get off my chest. In the comments below, let me know what your favorite shonen manga is that isn't an action series. There you go. And I will see you all for a spicy manga haul. Who knows what magical demographics we'll find there. Schatz der Welt, du hast hart dafür trainiert. Hier gibt es nichts mehr, das dich hält.